Howdy all and welcome to Lax Lives. I think it's time we play a little Infitech 2. Oh, alright, so I logged in today. Ooh, look, I finished my titanium pipes. Make sure everything's got plenty of steam flowing in here. Well, I think I still have too many engines. I'm not sure what the deal is, because these things claim to have thousands and thousands of steam in them half the time when I look at them. And you'd think that would all be in here. Why isn't it in here? Maybe there's like a pressure thing. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe there's just a certain amount of pressure. Honestly, though, I don't understand how these work either, because look at this. This has 123,000 stored RF in it. Why isn't that in this? Like, why can it make more RF than it can output? That doesn't make any sense to me either. Because I know these energy conduits can pull 640 RF, and this is only producing, like, it's not pulling 640 RF, is it? Maybe that's the case. It does pop up to 640 RF. Maybe I need better energy conduits. Are there better energy conduits? Energy conduit. Oh, there are. That's what I need to do. I need to make bigger ones. Ooh, I have energetic alloy, too. What did I use for these? Conductive iron. Interesting. All right. Well, I'm going to go do that, then, and see if this helps. I am going to crack. I'm going to crack this thing here. I'm just going to crack, period. I don't know. I don't know. Today has been a horrible... Well, it's not horrible. Today has been a day. I don't know how to describe it. Like, work went okay. I got up, and my internet apparently ran really slow last night, so my videos weren't done. That's usually the first thing I like to do in the morning, is get them up and running. And when I got up, the one video still had an hour and a half to upload, which is really weird, because one of them was mostly done last night. Look, I have so much of this stuff. One of them was almost finished last night when I went to bed, and that only left two more to upload. And so why the first one only took about an hour and a half total to do on its own, and the rest of them then took the next 8 hours and wasn't finished yet, I don't know. But, yeah. So anyways, that's not that irritating. I don't have a specific time when my videos need to be uploaded. I just put them up whenever I get to it, honestly. Because I am terrible at working ahead of time, I have to do the little finishing touches at the moment that I put up the videos. So, like at the end of the video is the end card, right? And then on the end card are the little last time on whatever episode, and you can click on that and it will take you to the previous episode, right? Well, I have to do that manually every time, and I guess it's all manually every time, but to tell it to go to a specific video is like the most ridiculous thing. Is it control? No. Shift. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so let's replace you with these and see if that works. Extract, and insert. Ooh, I think that might work. There we go. No, look, it's going back up. Okay, well, this is definitely pouring in faster. This is going to explode, though. This is not going to be able to handle this. Why am I even using this? I realized the other day, why am I not using Ender IO? You can filter Ender IO, right? I don't think I have any on me. Yeah. Alright, let's head back out and dump these off and check out Ender IO. Make sure you can filter that. Because I have Ender IO back at my base, right? And I can just take a peek at that. I have no idea where I'm at. And that is not the right map. Yep, I am totally flying the wrong direction. But, yeah, so that was the start of my day. And then... and then I like to listen to audiobooks when I go to work. And yesterday, I listened to an audiobook while I was traveling in my car. And it's on my tablet. I just put them on my tablet and listen to them from my tablet. And so today, when I went to leave, I listened to the tablet while I'm getting ready for work. And just take it with me, you know, out the door. And it's all nice. And it wouldn't play. It refused to work. Yeah, right here's some item conduit. Now, if I put you down... Well, I guess that was dumb. Is there one that's just all? Can I just have one that's all? There we go. Okay, if I put some item conduit here... There we go. Does this... This is... Oh, I can make a filter. That's right. That's how it works. I can make a filter. Okay, so I want to... I want to make a filter. And, anyways, so... I had to fill around with that. And I timed myself out on, what's an advanced item filter take? A Z logic controller, which takes something called a slice and splice, and a zombie, and solarium. Okay, that seems complicated. Let's just go with the easy one, a hopper with some paper. I think I can handle that one. I might even have a hopper free, and some paper for that matter. There's a hopper. I might not have any paper, though. I just use paper for something. There's some paper I do. Okay. Now, yep, stop trying to use that one, because that one is set up for when we ever we get the other parts that helmet made. Apparently, there is annealed copper in the game. It just takes a different recipe that I wasn't seeing. So my cheating the part in wasn't necessary. I apologize. Anyway, so I fiddled around with the tablet until I got the audiobook playing again. And of course it doesn't remember where I left off. And that was the whole reason I had been fiddling around with it before. The tablet I'm using has got a music section and an audiobook section. And for some reason, it won't remember where I left off in the music section. And I read that the trick to it is to put it in the audiobook section. And so I did that. And so then when I got back, it didn't work. It just didn't work. Like, it played. It played fine. And it acted like it was going to remember. And then it just stopped doing anything. Okay, I'm going to take this out then. You turn off. We'll wait for these to filter through here. Okay, now, if I put my item conduit in here, okay, now you're going to extract, and you're going to insert, but with a filter. I don't think this filter is big enough. I don't think my inventory is big enough. Here, let's do this. Okay, obviously I don't want cobble or andesite or, okay, I don't have enough room for that, or gravel. So, cobble, andesite, cobble, andesite, diorite, diorite, however you pronounce that, gravel. I don't like that this isn't that big, because you can see how much stuff is in here, and then you can see how much stuff is in here. I really don't have enough room for everything. Oh, and then you are also an insert. I hope that it puts it in here before it puts it in here. Okay. Yeah, it appears to be doing that. Good. Good, good. But it does look like I am going to have to make the more advanced filter for this, because that little filter isn't going to do it. So, and I'm going to wind up with some extra stuff here. It looks like limestone is another big one, so limestone can get added to the list here. We'll get rid of that. And the rest of this is just ridiculously full. So now what I think I need to do is I need to go back, I need to get my dolly, and I need to get another diamond chest, I guess, and swap these out. Right? I guess I should just brought all this stuff to begin with, honestly. So anyways, back to my story of my day. So, tablet stopped working with the song. I had to start, well, you know, I vaguely remember where I was at, and so I poked around until I find it, and had to move the files back into music to get them to work again. It would not play them from audiobook, even though it had played them from audiobook twice the day before. So I have no idea what changed overnight. Got that going again, and then so I finished getting ready for work, and the last thing I normally do is, well, I guess the last thing I do is put on my tie, and before that, the last thing I do, pull on my pants, put my belt through the belt buckle comes apart in my hand. I have no idea why, just came right apart. So then I go out, and there's two other adult males who live in the house, and I'm like, do either of you guys have a belt buckle I could borrow for a couple of days while I get, because I only own one belt. I'm not a clothes person, so I don't own a dozen different belts or something for different occasions. I got belt. That's it. And they're like, belt? I don't think I have any belt buckles. I don't have any belts with buckles. I'm like, okay, you just wore one yesterday. Yeah, but I don't know if the belt buckle comes off of it. And just continue to sit there reading a book. I've got to go to work, and I need a belt to hold my pants up, so I either need a belt, or does somebody have some rope? I guess I can rope my pants up until I can get a new belt. And, yeah, they finally got me a belt buckle, which then was a hassle because the belt buckle was a cheap belt buckle compared to the belt buckle that just came apart in my hands. And, so it didn't have a little piece that holds the whatever you call it in place, and so when I went to put my pants on, then the belt buckle twisted and the little piece that holds the belt in place went through, and so the belt just came undone again, and I finally fiddled with it until I got pants to stay on, because that would have been weird to go to work with pants that weren't staying on. Went to work, came home. Before I left for work, the sump pump here in the basement was not shutting off correctly. And so I fiddled with that for a little while. That's two diamond plates right there, right? Yes. Okay, you know what? I don't need mercury, and I don't need fluid extractor. I don't need copper plates on me. I don't need 10 or steel. I think I'm gonna... I'll keep those, though. I'm not sure if I'm done with those yet or not. All right, now I'm gonna need some iron ingots. I'm gonna need some gold ingots. We're gonna get some new chest pieces made here. Obviously, I could just grab my chest, bring it here, empty it, and then take it back out. But I think it'd be easier if I just had interchangeable chests, I think, would make my life easier. Or I could just add this chest and just have two chests over there to fill up. Anyway, so the sump. Yeah, the sump is not shutting off, obviously. Well, I mean, not obviously, but that was my story. Turns on, doesn't shut off. So we have because I'm the only one that works on any of this stuff here. Nobody else heard it. And what was that noise? But so there's like a metal pipe to hit the float switch. It's like a little, if you've never seen a sump, well, maybe you've seen the inside of a toilet, same principle. There's a ball with air in it that floats on top of the water. And I guess it's the opposite principle. In the toilet, when the ball gets to the top, it shuts off. In a sump, when the ball gets to the bottom, it turns on. That's not right. When the ball gets to the top in a toilet, it turns off. When it gets to the top in a sump, it turns on. And so the sump drains, and then when it reaches the bottom, it shuts off. So it turns on and drains the water, but then the sump just sits there going... Right, because it's just sucking in air, which it's not supposed to do. And so it seemed like it was working, but it wasn't working correctly. I go to work. I come home from work. The sump has been on probably the entire time I've been gone. You can hear it. You can hear it. It's loud. And it's not that loud, but it's loud enough that I can hear it before I even get in the house. And then when I get in the house, I can smell it because it is hot. And, never even noticed. Three people in the house, three adults in the house, never even noticed. And so, yeah, it was still running. So I fiddled with that, and, now I need those diamond plates. And, so then... then I unplugged it. Oop, no room in here. And I need glass. I think it's glass panes. I'm not sure why it's glass panes, to be honest, but that's the recipe. Glass panes. Well, I understand why it's glass panes here, because, you know, everything else is a flat sheet, but it's weird to me that you use glass in a diamond chest. It's better than using 8 diamond plates, for sure, because it took me forever to get the diamond plates I just used, let alone 8 of them. It's not hard to get the plate. Let me try that again. It's not hard to get the diamond block that you need to cut. It's that it takes so much power that it's hard to keep the cutter running while it's working on that. And I have to stand there and flop out batteries for like 20 minutes while it cuts through it, because I have such a terrible machine. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and drop this here, and then we can set this to input. Okay, you're empty. You're not quite full, but now we have all this beautiful space here ready to go. You guys are storing up RF like mad. Let's turn you back on. I think we're getting closer and closer to my preferred setup on this thing. Especially with all this steam right now. This should be pretty good here. I put this battery here in case it made extra RF, because these are always saying they're full of RF. But it has never gotten any extra RF stored into it. It stores a million. And right now it gets none. Aw, you know, the downside is now I can't see it work. Not from out here. I guess I could do it from here. Did you get anything yet? No. But so... I cut this trench so I could see how far down it was running. It's actually pretty far here in the middle. Yeah, it's farther in the middle than it is on the edge here. It's probably about halfway done at this point. It's only gotten 14 gold so far, though. I did not pick a good spot. It doesn't help that I strip mined a lot of that for gold ahead of time. So I get home from work. It's hot. You can smell it. You can hear it. Nobody cared. And I unplugged it. I beat the switch with a stick to see if like something was hung up in it, because it works. I don't understand. There's a slidey thing in it. And if I tap it real sharply, I mean, not like beat it with a hammer, just tap it with the stick sharply, it shuts off. But I can't walk over to the machine every time it needs to shut off and hit it. I just can't, because at 4 o'clock in the afternoon or 5 o'clock in the afternoon when I was working on it, it needed to empty the crock every 5 minutes. And I'm just not getting up every 5 minutes to fiddle with that thing. So, I let it empty the crock, I unplugged it, I ran to the hardware store, got a new float switch, after I watched some YouTube videos on it, because I have never dealt with that kind of stuff ever in my entire life, which is usually the excuse people here give when they don't want to do something. I'd never worked with it before. Me either. That's the problem. I've never worked with it either. Don't know why I have to be the one. Well, I do know why, because I've realized no one here is observant. No one here even pays attention to anything. Because when we end the story today, I made 7 electronic circuits. There's some other parts I'm going to need yet that I haven't got to. But I need more silicon. So let me check to see if there's enough power in here to do up some silicon for this helmet. It was disgusting. I have never really dealt with that kind of stuff. And I wound up, the crock is about shoulder deep in the floor. Like, if I'm laying on the floor, I can reach the bottom, which obviously is almost where you have to reach to deal with the sump pump. It sits on the bottom, and the float floats up, and when it gets almost straight up, that's when it turns on the sump, and then it goes down until it hangs down, and then it turns off the sump. So the sump, I guess, is about in the middle at the bottom, because it doesn't fill all the way to the top, because there's a emergency pump that comes on if it gets too close to the top. And so it's probably, the water only gets about 6 inches from the top. So any way you look at it, I am laying on the floor in the utility closet with a flashlight propped on the edge of this hole, elbow deep in cold water. The sides of the thing are covered in brown slime. The pump is covered in brown slime. If you have rusty water, it coats everything in a brown, gross slime. And so, yeah, it was disgusting. I finally got it fixed after running to the town and getting the part. And oh, you know, in the middle of it, I needed a pair of pliers, and I go back upstairs, and I've got brown gunk just running from my hand to my elbow. And I'm like, I need a pair of pliers. And they look at me, and the one guy goes, "Have you checked the drawer that I had just been digging around in for 15 minutes?" I'm like, "Yeah, I checked the drawer. It's across the room from you. You saw me looking in it." "Well, I didn't know what you were looking for." "I asked for pliers. What did you think I was looking for?" "Well, if you go into the laundry room, you can check the cupboard. In the laundry room, there might be some pliers in there. Thanks for your help." And so then I went and got a pair of pliers, and I had everything else I needed. Look at that work. Look at that work. Delicious. Actually, I probably need to go up and shut off my thing up here. I imagine it is emptied out and just wasting my charcoal at this point. Oh, maybe not. Oh, you're still going. All right. We'll let you keep going. So I got that all put in and running, and it seems to still be running, so I guess I did it right. And then after all that, I've got to edit and render yesterday's recording of Ark, at least part of it, so I can clear off enough hard drive space to record tonight. And so it's already almost 9 o'clock, and I haven't even started recording. Well, you're watching me do my first recording for the day. I got three videos that I normally do, and it's going to take some time to edit them when I'm done here. And oh yeah, I was checking power. Couldn't remember what I was doing. You make me some silicon. And so I need some lapis plates. I don't think I can use these lazurite plates. And I don't seem to see any other ones. It says lapis, right? On these advanced circuits. We'll play with the filter next time, I think. Maybe if I have a better day. So that part I've got the etched high voltage wiring. I mean, I just need a silicon bar for that. That's not the only piece. This is the part I need. And it says lapis. Or oh no, lazurite. Oh, sweet. Sweet. I didn't realize it could use lazurite. What was I looking at? I swear, something I looked at said it had to have lapis. I'll just use the things I got done. So I'm editing all that, anyways, my arc, and that's all edited. Well, the first episode is edited. And they call and tell me it's time for dinner. And so I go up for dinner, and the floor is covered in gritty stuff. And, so I'm like, what in the world is going on? And everybody's just sitting down having dinner, and I'm like, what is all over the floor? Oh, the 2-year-old got into the garlic salt and dumped the entire jar of garlic salt all over the kitchen and hallway. But we're gonna have dinner first, apparently, before we clean it up, so you can walk through it. Yeah. Okay. You're making those. I got those. I need silicon. Dang it. I need more room in my inventory always. Get out. I'll pick it up in a minute. I need silicon plates. All right, you can come back. Now get out. Oh, you know what? You can get out too. Alright, there's the silicon plates. Now, advanced forming press. I need you to take the silicon plate and the etchings. Alright, and then we come down here to the advanced assembly machine. And we put in our whatchamacallits here and this red one. And we got an advanced circuit. Alright, there's our advanced circuit. I'm a step closer. Beautiful. Alright, and then... Oh, I already had the advanced circuit. Whoops. So this is where we're at. I've got all the parts in here now except the heat somethings for this night vision helmet. I need two of these. Oh, this is where it takes the lapis plates. Yeah, this is where I saw it. So I need 8 lapis plates for this. And you can see it takes 2 electronic circuits. So that's 4. And then each one of these takes 1. So that's another 8. I don't have 8. Wow, I don't have 8. And this is just a bunch of plates. I have 7, don't I? All right, well, I've got to get one more circuit. I think I've got the stuff for it, though. Oh, you know what? I ran out of red alloy, and I was making more. That's where I left off. I did this while I was editing ARC today, because most of it's just scanning through it, looking for parts that I want to put up, and so... I was running back and forth doing this while I was listening to sections of ARC. Alright, well, that puts us in good position to finish the helmet. The quarry is doing well now. I guess I didn't... I don't know, just... Like, each one of those should be pulling out 640 RF to me, not 640 per... line, and it's only outputting 80. 8 times 4 is 380 times 4 is 320. So it already seems to me that those should have been more powerful than the engines. I just don't understand the math involved in these engines. But yeah, it's still not pulling out enough to keep these things empty. So I almost could go up to the next level, I guess. Oh, look, that's full now. Good thing we got you. Although, why that amber didn't come over here to join the other amber? Oh, because it's full. Interesting. One full chest of stuff pulled up by the quarry. One helmet almost ready to be made. I'd hope to get it made, but I didn't have time today, as you heard from my story. So hopefully next time we can get that done, and then I really want to start looking at going to the moon. I think that might be fun. I'd like to play with Galactic Craft some more. I've done it once before, but I want to see how difficult it is with the Greg Tech enhanced recipes. So, all right, click like if you like, subscribe to me for sure, and catch the next one, and I will talk to you later. We'll be right back.